Hi, today we're going to go over the basics for the anatomy table, located in room 211 in Hodges Library. Before we get started, we would like to remind our users that the content of the anatomy table is produced using real human cadavers. We expect all users to treat this content with the same deference and respect you would use for human cadavers. Please refrain from taking pictures of the table or any associated images with your personal devices, or uploading any saved images from the table to social media. We also ask our users to refer to the gross anatomy models by the provided designations, such as Caucasian male. If you have any questions regarding these policies, please see our resource guide. With these guidelines in mind, let's go to the table. The table has an easy-to-use touchscreen interface. We have loaded a male model from our gross anatomy models for us to use today. Notice the icons to the left side, which allow you to orient the model. There's a front and back view of the model as well. You can see the model from a side view, along with top and bottom views. Let's orient the model back to the front view to get started. There are two slider bars here on the bottom right of the screen. The upper is the brightness and the lower is the contrast. We'll start with the brightness slider, and as I move it to the left, it slowly removes layers starting with the skin and eventually going to the skeletal system. The bottom contrast slider displays finer, detailed structures such as the arteries, veins, and nerves. If I want to cut into the body, I can do so by using the slicer tool located on the bottom left of the screen. I'll simply select the tool, draw a line from any angle, then tap on the side I wish to remove. I'll use one finger to rotate the body in the direction I want to see it in. I can also zoom in with two fingers to get a closer look. Again, I could rotate the body using one finger, or if I wanted to move the body around the table, I could do so using two fingers. I can also move the slice we made by using the slider on the bottom left side of the control layout. By moving the slicer bar left or right, we can move the slice up and down from the body at the angle we created earlier. By selecting the visibility menu, which looks like an eye icon on the bottom right of our screen, I can now see different menus of systems of the body. I can choose to turn all of these off by clicking the check mark in the bottom left-hand corner of the menu, and then choose the systems I would like to see by clicking the check mark next to those systems. Let's select the muscular, skeletal, and cardiovascular systems. And we can see that those systems are the only ones we see. The exploration tool, which is the profile icon with the question mark to the left of the visibility menu, provides three options. I can extract different parts of the body by using the removal tool on the left and selecting the structure I want to remove, automatically labeling as we go. Clicking undo will bring the structures back in the order that they were removed. The button on the right is the isolation tool, which will allow us to isolate different parts of the body. I'll select the right external oblique muscle, and now we see the muscle is isolated from the rest of the body. We can track the path of blood by using the blood flow tool, which is in the center of the exploration tool menu. If we select a vessel and tap on the blood flow tool once, we can see the colored bubbles that are moving in the direction that the blood would flow through the vessel. Tapping the icon a second time highlights the path of blood flow in a solid color, and tapping it a third time labels all of the vessels along this path. Another helpful tool is the dissection tool. You can use this tool on the bottom of your screen, just to the left of the slicer tool we used earlier. This will present you with several options. First, We'll use the freehand dissection tool on the far left. This tool will allow you to make an incision somewhere on the body. Select the incision you want to make to go into a layer. I'll then select OK to penetrate all structures. Then we'll wait for it to load and select the incision again. Now we can go layer by layer by layer, having it label as we go along. We could also use the straight line icon located to the right of the freehand dissection tool to draw a line and dissect on one side of it. You may also choose to annotate on top of the body, which you can do by selecting the pen tool located on the upper left-hand side of our tool layout. Next, pick a color and then draw on the table to indicate or identify areas you'd like to highlight. You can also add a text box to add custom labels. You can then save a screenshot by going to the camera icon located directly above the pen tool on the left side of your screen. Select a flash drive, choose a file name, and then select Save. Another useful tool is the Action menu, located on the bottom right of your screen. To access the Action menu, simply select the body part. You will then see the rainbow icon activate. By clicking the rainbow icon, we are provided with 9 different options to interact with the structure. We can remove or bring back the structure by clicking the checkmark icon. We can make a structure transparent by clicking the ghost icon, and make it opaque again by clicking this icon once more. We can color a body part by selecting the color icon. From here, we can choose from 20 different colors to select. We can label the selected structure by tapping the annotation tool. If we select a bone, we can click the Origin and Insertion button to see the locations of muscle origins and insertions. Origins are labeled in red, while insertions are labeled in blue. Notice how these are automatically labeled for us. We can also access the Blood Flow tool within the Action menu. 2 dissection options are available for us to use as well. We can choose to do a freehand or a straight line dissection. When we use these tools in the Action menu, the dissection cuts only affect the structure we have selected. To reverse the dissections, simply select the Restore icon on the bottom right of your menu. We can also test our anatomy knowledge by using Quiz Mode. Select the flashcard icon from the bottom of your screen to choose from different ready-made quizzes. When you are finished with your quiz, your score will be displayed, and if you select Show Details, a report of your performance will be provided. You can keep track of your progress by selecting Export Results. Pick your flash drive, choose a file name, and click Save. So there you go. We've gone over an overview of basic tools offered by the Gross Anatomy models. But we're not done. By selecting the Start button in the left-hand corner, I'll get a menu of other options to explore. This includes the High Definition Regional Anatomy, which, if selected, allows me to see different areas, systems, or organs of the body. I can then select to see which one I want to look at specifically. Let's close this and go back to the menu. If we select the Case Library, we see that it provides a repository of hundreds of images compiled by the Anatomage group that are sectioned into different folders, indicating, among other things, different areas of the body and a variety of animal models. Thanks for joining us. Come and explore the table yourself. Remember, we're always happy to help by setting up a consultation with one of us or another Health Sciences team member. You can also find more information by going to our website at libguides.utk.edu /anatomytable.